Hello children, do you remember about 12th chemistry, that is surface chemistry? Last class we covered about what is adsorption, what are the types of adsorption, what is adsorbate, what is adsorbent, and what are the factors that is affecting your adsorption. In that we have seen there are four important factors which is affecting your adsorption. What are those? The first one is the nature of adsorbate. Second is the nature of adsorbent, that is your surface. Third one is your pressure and fourth is your temperature. So up to first three factors we have completed, and today let us see the factor that is temperature, how the way it is affecting your adsorption. So now let us see, before going to see that concept, all of you know your adsorption is a exothermic reaction. So in which reaction? There is evolve or release of heat. Now again if you increase the heat, so what will happen? Your adsorption becomes desorption. If you decrease the heat, then your desorption becomes adsorption, because it is a reversible process. Okay, so now let us see in terms of graph how it will be. So this is your pressure, this is your volume. Now initially let it be at 190 degree, 3 Kelvin, your volume is V3. Now increase your temperature. That's what we are going to check. By increasing the temperature, how the way it is affecting the adsorption. Now suppose increase it to temperature that is your 247 Kelvin around. When you increase this temperature, what you find that your volume is reduced to V2. Higher volume now reduced to lower volume. Again increase the temperature. It is around 273 Kelvin. What you find? Again your volume is reduced to V3, V2, V1. Am I right? So what you are observing from this? Increase in temperature, the rate of adsorption decreases. Volume decreases means what? Your rate of adsorption decreases. Am I right? So what you have to write? Increase in temperature, your adsorption volume decreases. Am I right? Or the same you can say it as adsorption. Now this is the reaction where you are increasing your enthalpy as positive, means again you are adding the temperature. So what it will happen? It will becomes desorption, means your layer will remove and go out of the surface. So that is called as desorption. Now again increase it. Sorry, it is increased desorption. Now reduce it. So your enthalpy make it as negative. So what it will get? Adsorption. So by reducing the temperature, your adsorption occurs finely. Whereas by increasing the temperature, your adsorption becomes desorption. Clear about it? The how the way temperature is affecting your adsorption process. It is inversely proportional. Clear? Now let us see the another important topic, that is called as catalyst. I think all of you very habituated with this term catalyst. What do you mean by the term catalyst? It is a substance that will change the rate of reaction without it being consumed. Catalyst वो ऐसा substance है जो reaction का rate को बदला देता है, लेकिन अपने आप consume नहीं होता. That is the speciality of catalyst. So make a note of it. What is catalyst? A substance that changes the rate of reaction without being consumed itself. So without being consumed itself, if it is changing the rate of reaction, then that is called as catalyst. So usually changing the rate of reaction means either it will make the reaction faster or it will make the reaction slower. But usually we use this to expedite or make our reaction faster, quicker. Slower, that actually when you slow down the process or reaction, that is very highly poisonous. We use it even for slow down the reaction also, we use the catalyst. But maximum time catalyst is used for speed up the process or making the reaction faster or quicker. Now let us see some example how the way it is affecting. See one example. Potassium chlorate. Take the potassium chlorate. Now heat it. If you heat it, what you will find? You will find potassium chloride plus O2. Am I right? Huh? Just balance it. It is 3. Now, if you do this reaction, you take potassium chlorate, KClO3, you will get potassium chloride and oxygen as the output. Do you know how much time it takes for this reaction? 4 hours. Now, the same reaction, you just give one catalyst, that is manganese dioxide, MnO2. Can you imagine how much time it will take to process this? Only 15 minutes. What is 4 hours? That is 4 into 60, 240 minutes. It will take only 15 minutes. Now you can imagine the role of catalyst. Almost around 16 times it makes the process faster. So take the same 2KClO3, that is potassium chloride, apply the heat along with MnO2. That is, this is nothing but your catalyst. What you will get? Same KCl plus 3O2. It takes only 15 minutes, whereas it is taking 4 hours. Now, are you getting clarity how the way catalyst is expediting or making faster your reactions? Clear? Now let us see the type of catalyst. Make the heading types of catalyst. See, there are basically two types of catalyst. One is called as homogeneous catalyst, the other is called as heterogeneous catalyst. Now, based on what factor you say that it is a homogeneous catalyst, and based on which factor you say that it is a heterogeneous catalyst? It is nothing but whatever you are taking your reactant, if that phase of reactant as well as that phase of catalyst both remain same, we say it is homogeneous catalytic reaction. If the phase of the reactant and the catalyst what you are using is differing, then that is called as heterolytic or heterogeneous catalytic reaction. So it is nothing but the phase of the reactant and the catalyst that defines the types of catalyst which is used for chemical reactions. So let us see what are those types. One is homogeneous, second is heterogeneous. So now let us see this difference, how the way you are going to differentiate between these homogeneous and heterogeneous. Let us see. So, homogeneous, heterogeneous. Already mentioned, your phase of the catalyst is same as that of reactant, then it is called as homogeneous or homolytic. Heterogeneous, homo means same, hetero means different. Simple concept. So, here first point is in terms of phase. So phase of catalyst and reactant remain same. Here the phase differ. Are you getting? How the way that difference is occurring in case of a homogeneous and heterogeneous? Now let us see with respect to some example. So when it is coming to this example, you take sulfur dioxide plus half oxygen you take. Then what it will give you? SO3. Now in this case you take NO, that is nitrogen monoxide. This is nothing but which is used as catalyst. This is also gas, oxygen also gas, sulfur dioxide also gas. So this is nothing but your reactant. This NO is nothing but your catalyst. So all are in same phase, hence homogeneous. Now here let us see one example. Then what you write? 2SO2 plus O2, it will give you SO3. What you are going to use here? V2O5, that is vanadium pentoxide, V2O5. It is in which state? Solid. Oxygen in gas, sulfur dioxide gas. So what you are finding? This reactant in gaseous phase, whereas this catalyst is in the solid phase. So phase is different. Are you getting clarity how the way? You can even take another example also, that is H2O aqueous you take. Then if you apply your I minus, that is also in the state of aqueous, that will give you H2O plus half O2. Here your water in aqueous state, your I dash also, I minus also in aqueous state. So both are in same state or same phase. Here you can take another example, that is N2 plus 3H2. You know nitrogen gas, hydrogen is gas. Take the iron which is solid. So this is gas. This is gas, but this is solid. So what you will get? Ammonia NH3. We should not bother about the product. It may be in the any phase. Our differentiation is based on the phase of reactant and the phase of the catalyst, not on the phase of the product. So the reactant is in terms of gas, whereas your catalyst in terms of solid. So hence this is the way they differ. That is the first point of importance, that is difference in phase. Now let us see the second point. That is, in case of a homogeneous, a reaction takes place either in the liquid or gaseous phase. Whereas in case of heterogeneous, always your catalyst, what you are occurring, your reaction occurs on the surface of catalyst. Because your catalyst is always the solid form. That is the difference. So here your reaction occurs in liquid or gaseous phase. Whereas here a reaction occurs on the surface of solid catalyst. Okay, that is the one of the most important difference between this. Now coming to surface area. In the case of a homogeneous catalytic reaction, there is no role of surface area. But coming to heterogeneous, your rate of reaction is directly proportional to your catalytic or catalytic or catalytic solid surface, because most of the catalyst which you are using in heterogeneous are solid. Okay, that is one of the third important difference. That is, your rate of reaction does not depend on area of catalyst. For us, it is surface area, your rate of reaction is directly proportional to surface area of catalyst. That is one of the most important factor. Now let us see the fourth important factor. That is, in case of a homogeneous, your catalyst dissolve in the solution. Whereas in the case of heterogeneous, your catalyst never dissolve in the solution. So once your catalyst dissolve in the solution, it's difficult to separate. Which is dissolving, mixing, it's difficult to separate or not. But in heterogeneous, your catalyst will not dissolve. So it's easy to separate. That is one of the important difference. That is, your catalyst dissolve. So is not easy to separate. So not easy to separate. Here, fourth point, your catalyst not dissolve. So easy to separate. Now tell me, when your catalyst is dissolving, which reaction will be faster? Obviously, your homogeneous reaction will be faster, whereas your heterogeneous will be slower. So that is your fifth point. What is your fifth point? Is nothing but here the rate of reaction is faster. Here your rate of reaction is slower. Because the thing which is not mingling, forcefully you are doing it. So obviously it will be taking more time. Yes or no? So this is the important difference between the catalyst and its type. Now let us see, in that catalyst, one more very, very highly important concept called as enzyme. So what is enzyme? This is nothing but biocatalyst, which is present in our whole body. Now what is the role of that enzymes? Do you know? If you take a meal and enzymes are not present in our body, how many years it will take to digest the food? It is estimated that around 30 years will be taken by this body to digest a single meal if enzymes are not present in our body. So just imagine how it makes the reactions in our body faster. 10 to the power 8 to 10 to the power 16 times faster the reaction. Then only we are able to digest the food morning what we are taking, and lunch time we are feeling hungry, afternoon time. So am I right? Now you can understand the role of biocatalyst.